Hi guys, we've prepared a quick review of minor improvements recently added to VSDC. Let's bring you up to date. The first improvement is for those who often work with overlays. Sometimes you need to select an object, overlapped and hidden by another file in the scene. It can be tricky. To help you out, we've added a checkbox to the Options menu. You'll find it in the Editor Options, and it's named Allow for moving selected objects even if overlaid by other objects. Easy to remember. The checkbox is active by default. You just need to press the Alt key when selecting the object on the timeline. Then you can just grab and move the object around the scene, even if another file covers it. And since we're already in the Options menu, let's take a quick look at the two new sections, Timeline Colors and Internet Connection. The Timeline Colors menu allows you to change the colors of the blocks on the timeline. For example, blocks of media files, effects, text objects, and so on. This makes navigation easier, especially when you have a lot of files and effects on the timeline. The Internet Connection menu now allows you to choose how often you want to get notifications about VSDC updates. Plus, we've added an option to configure a proxy for those who have problems activating the pro version or downloading templates from our server. However, if you do encounter these types of problems, we suggest that you first contact our technical support team, because we may find a solution that will be easier than configuring your proxy. Okay, there are two more timeline settings we'd like to introduce. First, you can now change the time format in the top left corner on the timeline to milliseconds or frames. The second option is called Delay in Scene Duration Calculation. Here is how it works. When you grab a file on the timeline and start moving it, even before you select its final position, the recalculation of the scene time already begins. You may notice that the numbers are changing and the storyboard is reloading. It can look inconvenient sometimes, but with the new option, you can delay the recalculation process so that you avoid distraction and confusion when moving objects around the timeline. And finally, one of the most long-awaited features is Group File Editing Update. Ta-da! Group editing was pretty limited until the last VSDC release, but now you can select as many objects on the timeline as you want and change their settings simultaneously. The only tricky part is, you should keep an eye on the type of objects you are selecting to make sure they have common parameters to change. Parameters that are common to all objects are highlighted in white. Parameters that are different for each object are highlighted in green. For example, change the volume settings for all of them, or mute all of them. Unfortunately, you still can't apply effects to multiple objects simultaneously, but there is a workaround. Here is what you can do. Select the desired video files on the timeline, then drag the desired effect to the scene from the template window. Notice, to the scene, not to the timeline. And voila! The effect is applied to all the files you've selected. If you follow these steps, it will work on any effect, except for transition effects. But we are working on a more efficient solution, so stay tuned. That's it for today. Let us know what you think about these updates. Thank you for watching. Until next time.